being a heavy puncher is definitely a blessing for all boxers.
Thomas trying to hold on. Serious trouble.
Not every punch knocks their opponents down or out, but just about every shot they land does some damage. With the controversial way some bouts have been scored recently, who wants to leave the outcome in the hands of the judges? We present you the hardest punchers with highest knockout percentages among all of the current champions in boxing today. Gwozdik turned professional in 2014, and within 2 years he would knock out former contender Najib Mohammadi, and within 4 win the interim WBC light heavyweight title by unanimous decision over Mehdi Ammar.
At some point in my boxing career, I started feeling that I need something, change something. That's how I met Teddy, and who know better than Teddy how to do this?
Known as the Nail, he really is the epitome of that, with his stinging jab being the best weapon in his arsenal. In December 2018, he knocked out Adonis Stevenson in the 11th to take WBC title.
Stevenson is hurt. Stevenson in big trouble. Must take a right hand. Stevenson is down.
The 30-year-old southpaw from the Big Easy, now living in Houston, is one of the sport's most exciting up-and-coming talents.
Mike Tyson's actually somebody that I always looked up to. Of course, I can't be like Tyson, but you know, I can still go out and knock people out.
Yeah, he's already
down. He goes again from the left hand.
Having turned professional in 2012, Ruger was regarded as one of the best fighters in his weight class.
Flanagan is Basie. Oh, big straight up! There goes Flanagan!
He outclassed Kirill Relich in a 6-round TKO to become the new WBA Super Lightweight Champion and punch his spot in the World Boxing Super Series Final. IBF welterweight champion Errol Spence Jr. is finally building enough of a resume to change the conversation. Spence's near perfect combination of defense, power punching, and the mastery of distance left unbeaten lightweight champion Mikey Garcia void of options offensively.
My boxing IQ is high, and I have a lot of different things that I bring to the table except just, you know, pure brute strength.
Spence expects to fight Terence Crawford, and that will be one of the biggest in boxing, only after facing Sean Potter and the winner between Keith Thurman and Manny Pacquiao. Berchelt is pretty much universally regarded as the top man at Super Featherweight right now.
Able to move around a little bit. Oh, that is huge left hook that sends Barros down to the floor.
The WBC title holder is in his prime at age 27. He fights in an exciting style, and he is on a 15-fight win streak. 14 of those wins by stoppage.
Some guy. Overhand right that catches Barros again.
Look at Berchelt on the attack here at the end of 6.
The fight that Berchelt really wants is a fight against WBA and WBO lightweight champion Vasily Lomachenko.
Claro que sí, creo que Lomachenko.
I think Lomachenko is a great fighter, but I want to face the champions of the division and then move up in weight and go after Lomachenko. He's a great fighter.
Ir por Lomachenko.
My nickname is Monster. If I leave a great result, that is going to leave a great image for the boxing fans all over the world.
Inoue won his first world title in only his 6th professional fight, capturing the WBC light flyweight crown with victory over Adrian Hernandez in 2014. The 26-year-old possesses incredible power, speed and timing. He has the sound fundamental of a good boxer. The unbeaten Wunderkind from Japan, after a second round knockout over previously unbeaten Emmanuel Rodriguez, will go on to face Nonito Donaire in the showpiece of the tournament, with the winner coming out with the Muhammad Ali Trophy.
Nonito has a great career record as well as a great fighter, and I respect him a lot, and I look forward to him.
A fearsome flurry, and he's down! Lights out for Rodriguez!
Boasting an impressive record of 21-0 with 20 KOs, Davis has shown that he has what it takes to be the next superstar in boxing.
Oh, that's why. Lightning quick power!
He is a two-time world champion and the undoubtedly the biggest name in the super featherweight division.
I'm a dog, you know, and I will continue to be a dog. And, you know, I'm going to continue to listen to my team. You know, and we're going to take over boxing.
There are some big names in featherweight that could provide Davis with a chance to add a legitimate scalp to his resume. Acosta made his pro debut in November 2012, winning all his fights inside the distance, and his only loss came against Kosei Tanaka.
That's always my desire to give a good show, and I think that the fans always expect a good show. What I do want to tell everyone is to not look away and pay attention to the fight, because at any second it can end in a knockout.
Oh! Oh, he's not getting enough!
He won the vacant WBO belt with a 10th round stoppage win over Juan Alejo in December 2017 and made 3 successful defenses.
I don't know if that's gonna help him. Oh! Certainly.
His nickname Tito harkens back to a fighter many Puerto Ricans loved for his big punching style, Felix Trinidad. Deontay Wilder is one of the most prominent heavyweight American boxers of his generation.
Vern hasn't shown the work rate he's getting. As Vern goes down in round one!
His ability to deliver brutal knockouts have helped him carve his own special place in the boxing world.
I know who I am, I know what I stand for, I know what I represent. And anyone want to test me and doubt me who I am, then I'm willing to prove you wrong. I'm the best in the world, and that's what I feel, no matter what opinion it is.
However, he hasn't been able to earn as much fame as his accomplishments in the boxing warrants, which has been put down to his lack of orthodox boxing skills and his nice guy persona.
And what you will see is what I display. I will knock this fool out. He may not get up. It ain't no hoping and wishing that he gonna get up, because he may not.
Throw with him and
The 34-year-old Russian turned pro in June 2013, but has had only 14 pro fights, all of them win by stoppage.
Никто не хотел со мной боксировать. Было да, что меня тут избегают, я не знаю почему.
Ferocious puncher defended his IBF light heavyweight title last time when Radivoj Karadžić was halted on his feet 14 seconds into the 5th round.
Archer better be it. Will it be 14 for 14 as he comes out and this fight is over?
Any rival champion would be a richly appealing fight. They are all top quality. Beterbiev versus either Sergey Kovalev, Aleksandar Gvozdik or Dmitry Bivol would be unmissable.
Listen to a decision as a professional, and down goes Holling, and that's it. He will still not have to listen to the cards.